A very good afternoon. You're watching the midday news on Rajya Sabha Television. I'm Ashwarya Kapoor, and here are the headlines. Prime Minister launches a mega countrywide movement, Swachhta Hi Seva. Spiritual gurus, celebrities, students and jawans pledge support to the fortnight-long campaign in the run-up to the fourth anniversary of a Swachh Bharat mission on 2nd of October. Centre relaxes norm to raise the overseas borrowing, decides to impose restrictions on non-essential imports. Move part of five decisions taken to check current account deficit and falling rupee. Decision following Prime Minister's review meeting with RBI Governor, Finance Minister and other key officials. Vice President M. Venkaiah Naidu to hold delegation-level talks with the Serbian President in the afternoon today. MOUs to be signed between the two sides, along with the release of commemorative stamps of Nikola Tesla and Swami Vivekanand. Vice President to also address a special session of the Serbian National Assembly. Five militants belonging to the Lashkar-e-Toyba and the Hizbul Mujahideen killed in an encounter in Kulgam in Jammu and Kashmir. Security forces recover weapons and warlike stores from encounter site in Chaugam. And unbeaten India to play Maldives in the final of the SAF football tournament in Dhaka in the evening today. India look to bag their eighth title at the event. Our top story this afternoon, Prime Minister Narendra Modi today launched the mega countrywide Swachhta Hi Seva movement. The fortnight-long campaign was launched through video conferencing, where the Prime Minister interacted with a cross-section of people, including celebrities, spiritual gurus, students, jawans and common citizens from 18 locations in the country. The campaign will end on 2nd of October, which also marks the fourth anniversary of the Swachh Bharat mission. The celebrations of the Gandhi's 150th birth anniversary will also commence that day. And during this period, a series of activities have been planned. Swachhta Gram Sabhas and Shramdan will be held in all 2,50,000 Gram Panchayats. Massive sanitation drives will be organized in all the industrial estates. Over 10 lakh registered doctors will hold a local Swachhta clinic, and 9 lakh Asha workers will hold cleanliness drives at primary health centres. A Swachhta rally will also be organised by the school children. The campaign will culminate with Mahatma Gandhi International Sanitation Convention in the national capital from 29th of September to 2nd of October. And launching the campaign, the Prime Minister exhorted the people to fulfil Gandhiji's dream of a clean India.
आज 15 सितंबर का यह दिन अपने आप में बहुत ऐतिहासिक है। ऐतिहासिक इसलिए क्योंकि आज की सुबह एक नया प्राण, एक नया उत्साह, एक नया सपना लेकर के आई है। आज आप मैं 125 करोड़ देशवासी स्वच्छता ही सेवा के संकल्प को फिर से एक बार दोहराने जा रहे हैं। आज से लेकर 2 अक्टूबर यानी पूज्य बापू की जयंती तक देश भर में हम सभी नई ऊर्जा के साथ, नए जोश के साथ अपने देश को, अपने भारत को स्वच्छ बनाने के लिए श्रमदान करेंगे, अपना योगदान देंगे। दिवाली के समय हम देखते हैं घर कितना ही साफ सुथरा क्यों न हुआ हो, लेकिन दिवाली आते ही पूरा परिवार घर के हर कोने की स्वच्छता में लग जाता है। वैसे ही हमें भी देश के हर कोने में सफाई का यह स्वभाव हर महीना, हर वर्ष बनाते रहना होगा। 4 वर्ष पहले जो अभियान शुरू हुआ, स्वच्छता का आंदोलन, अब एक महत्वपूर्ण पड़ाव पर आ पहुंचा है। हम गर्व के साथ कह सकते हैं कि राष्ट्र का हर तबका, हर संप्रदाय, हर जाति, हर उम्र के मेरे साथी इस महाअभियान को आगे बढ़ा रहे हैं.
And celebrities and spiritual gurus thanked the Prime Minister for his guidance and initiative in the Swachh Bharat mission.
चार वर्ष पहले आपने देश का परिचय करवाया इस अभियान से और तब से अपने आप को एक देश का नागरिक समझकर मुझे लगा कि ये मेरा कर्तव्य है कि मैं इस अभियान के साथ जुड़ूं और जो कुछ भी एक व्यक्तिगत तौर पे हो सके उसे करने का प्रयत्न करता रहूंगा.
Like any monument, the foundation has to be strong. That foundation is the health of our people. The health of our people cannot be there without cleanliness and raising the level of sanitation and safe drinking water for the people. You mentioned diarrhea and other sicknesses that have plagued our nation for years. We can reduce or hopefully even eliminate if every one of us support this movement.
I've been traveling across the country and it is a joy to see, particularly in Tamil Nadu, most of the villages are spick and span. You hardly see any garbage in the villages of Tamil Nadu. We still need to work on the small towns and cities, but the villages have taken the first initiative, thanks to the government here and in the center making this happen, because the necessary impetus was needed.
जो कुछ पिछले सदियों में कमी रही वो आपके द्वारा पूरी होती दिख रही है कि फिर जल्दी ही जो भारत है वो विश्व गुरु होने जा रहा है वो हमें दिख रहा है प्रतीत हो रहा है.
इतिहास केवल भारत सरकार की आंदोलन नहीं, ये जनता के आंदोलन, देश के आंदोलन, हर नागरिक के आंदोलन, बच्चों का आंदोलन, बुड्ढों का आंदोलन, शिक्षकों का आंदोलन, एक आंदोलन करके भारत को स्वच्छ बनाएंगे, भारत को विश्व गुरु बनाएंगे. ऐसे गुरु बनाने का नेतृत्व आपने लिया, इसके लिए आपको बारंबार बधाई, धन्यवाद, प्रणाम, नमस्ते.
56,000 से अधिक स्वेच्छाग्रही हम लोगों ने पूरे प्रदेश के अंदर प्रत्येक ग्राम पंचायतों में तैनात करने के अलावा प्रदेश के अंदर जो पहले से ही सफाई कर्मचारी थे इन सबको भी इसके लिए तैयार किया. 2,20,000 से अधिक राज मिस्त्रियों का विशेष प्रशिक्षण इस दौरान हम लोगों ने प्रदेश के अंदर करवाया और विगत 17 माह के दौरान हम लोग प्रदेश के अंदर 1,36,00,000 इज्जत घरों का निर्माण करने में सफल रहे हैं. और आपकी प्रेरणा और आपके आशीर्वाद से हम ये कह सकते हैं कि बेसलाइन सर्वे के अनुरूप हम लोग 2 अक्टूबर 2018 तक पूरे प्रदेश को पूरी तरह खुले में शौच से मुक्त करने में सफल हो जाएंगे.
मैं समझता हूं एक आक्रामक मानसिकता है, दूसरा निराशिक मानसिकता है, माने एक अग्रेसिव टेंडेंसी, दूसरा डिप्रेसिव टेंडेंसी. ये दो मुख्य कारण है गंदगी फैलाने का. क्यों? इन दोनों मानसिकता में संवेदनशीलता नहीं होती है. तो इनसे ऊपर उठना हो तो आप जैसे देश के प्रधान इनके दिल में, इनके मन में भर दे, विश्वास भर दे कि हम इस देश को ऊपर ले जा सकते हैं, स्वच्छ दिखा सकते हैं.
इस अभियान का हम ये असर देख रहे हैं कि हमारे प्रशासनिक अधिकारी भी इसमें जागरूक है और हमारी म्युनिसिपल कॉरपोरेशन भी जो है, अब हम गली गली में वो सदाएं सुनते हैं सुबह जो उन्होंने गाने की शक्ल में बना करके लोगों को प्रेरणा देते हैं कि अपने घर का कचरा ला करके उसमें डालें. तो उससे हमारे पूरे जो आसपास के इर्द गिर्द के इलाके हैं उसमें काफ़ी साफ सफाई है.
ई आह्वानम എല്ലാ പൗരന്മാരുടെയും ഹൃദയത്തിൽ സ്പർശിച്ചിട്ടുണ്ടെന്നും എല്ലാത്തരം ആളുകളിൽ ഈ പദ്ധതി മുന്നോട്ട് കൊണ്ടുപോകാൻ സഹായിക്കുമെന്നും ഞാൻ വിശ്വസിക്കുന്നു. പ്രകൃതി സംരക്ഷണം, അതുപോലെ തന്നെ പരിസരവൃത്തി, ശുചിത്വം, ജലസംഭരണം തുടങ്ങിയ കാര്യങ്ങളെക്കുറിച്ച് മഠം സ്ഥിരമായി ബോധവൽക്കരണം ചെയ്യുകയും ഈ കർമ്മ പദ്ധതികളെല്ലാം നടപ്പാക്കുകയും ചെയ്തിട്ടുണ്ട്. പിന്നെ വന്ന് ശരിയായ ശൗചാലയം ഇല്ലാത്തത് കൊണ്ട് നാട്ടുമ്പുറങ്ങളിലെ സ്ത്രീകൾ വളരെ വേദന അനുഭവിച്ചിട്ടുണ്ട്.
And students, Jawan and other ordinary citizens also pledged their support to the movement.
RTVP ki sabhi chokiyon ne Ladakh se lekar Arunachal Pradesh tak sabhi simavarti kshetron mein ek ek gaon ko god liya hai aur yahan par RTVP nirantar lagatar swachhta abhiyan chala rahi hai. Hamari RTVP Lukung Choki dwara is sthaniya pehgaon ke ilake ke 5 गांवों में लगातार स्वच्छता अभियान चला रखा है और आने वाले 15 दिनों में हम लगातार इस स्वच्छता अभियान को चलाएंगे.
हमारे विद्यालय के पड़ोसी गांव है औफुलिया. सर, आज यह गांव डिब्रूगढ़ का सबसे सुंदर एवं स्वच्छ गांव है. यहां की जनता ने स्वच्छ भारत अभियान को एक जन आंदोलन के रूप में अपनाया है. सर, आपके आह्वान पर सन 2014 से संचालित स्वच्छता अभियान ही इस परिवर्तन का कारण है. आज इस गांव के हर घर में शौचालय है, पानी के स्रोत निर्मल है, गली एवं सड़कें साफ और सुंदर है. अब स्वच्छता यहां के लोगों की जीवनचर्या है.
सहकारी संस्था के माध्यम से जो आपने विचार रखा है स्वच्छता का, उसका आज बड़ा वटवृक्ष बन गया है. यहाँ पर जो भी स्वच्छता का काम हो रहा है उसमें सहकारी संस्था वाले पूरे तन मन से जुड़े हुए हैं और हमारा मेन लक्ष्य है नारी का उत्थान, महिलाओं का उत्थान. के लिए हम लोग जो भी काम कर रहे हैं उसमें कई महिलाओं को तो पंचायत से भी जुड़ी है और पंचायत का नेतृत्व करते करते महिलाओं स्वच्छता अभियान में सबसे ज़्यादा गौर कर रही है और स्वच्छता के लिए सबसे ज़्यादा जरूरी महिलाओं का काम है, क्योंकि महिला घर घर जा सकती है, सबको समझा सकती है, उसी ट्रेनिंग हम महिलाओं को भी देते हैं.
आज मेरा गांव स्वच्छता की ओर अग्रसर है. आज से 4 साल पहले गांव बिल्कुल गंदा, जगह जगह सड़ा हुआ, जगह जगह शौचालय पड़ा हुआ मिलता था, लेकिन आज आज सरकार के आपके प्रयास से आज मेरा गाँव और मेरा जिला 2 अक्टूबर को ODF होने जा रहा है. इसके लिए भी मैं बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद देना चाहता हूँ सर.
And after the launch of the campaign, Prime Minister Narendra Modi offered a shramdan by sweeping the premises of a Baba Sahib Ambedkar Higher Secondary School in Delhi's Paharganj. He also interacted with the students there. Several union ministers also offered their services on the day by sweeping several places. These include Union Ministers Rajnath Singh, Dharmendra Pradhan, Ravi Shankar Prasad and others. On to some other news now. As part of efforts to check the rising current account deficit, the government will relax norms for raising overseas borrowing and impose restrictions on the non-essential imports. The commodities on which imports will be cut down will be decided after consultations with the concerned ministries. And other steps include a removal of restrictions on masala bonds. It decided to review mandatory hedging conditions for infrastructure loans. The government also proposed to remove the exposure limits of up to 20% of an FPI bond portfolio to a single corporate group and 50% to a single company. The decisions were taken at a meeting chaired by Prime Minister Narendra Modi to review state of the economy. Finance Minister Arun Jaitley, Niti Aayog Vice Chairman Rajiv Kumar, Economic Advisory Council Chairman Bibek Deb Roy and RBI Governor Urjit Patel were among those who attended the meeting, where issues like the depreciation in the rupee and fuel prices were discussed. The two-day meeting will conclude today.
That to address the issue of expanding current account deficit, the government will take necessary steps to cut down non-essential imports and also increase exports. Ye kaun se honge non-essential imports अगले कुछ दिनों में जिस जिस एरिया में ये करना होगा उन मिनिस्ट्रीज को कंसल्ट करके नेसेसरी डिसीजंस विल बी टेकन एज एंड व्हेन दे आर टेकन दे विल बी अनाउंस्ड.
Exports rose at the fastest pace in 3 months to reach $27.84 billion in August on account of a growth in petroleum products, engineering, pharma and gems and jewellery shipments. According to the data released by the Commerce Ministry, imports also grew by 25.41% in August due to costlier crude oil shipments, and the trade deficit in August came down to $17.4 billion as against $12.72 billion in August last year. The exports of petroleum products, engineering, pharma and gems and jewellery in August rose by 43.25%, 31.81%, 28.52% and 34.76% respectively. The gold imports in August jumped by 92.62% to $3.64 billion. And on to news from the Vice President's three-nation tour. Vice President M. Venkaiah Naidu will be accorded an official welcome in Serbia in the afternoon today. He will hold a meeting with the President of Serbia and there will be signing of MOUs following the delegation-level talks. And India-Serbia Business Forum meeting is also slated. The Vice President will also hold talks with the Speaker of the National Assembly there and also address a special session of the Assembly later today. And after Serbia, Vice President M. Venkaiah Naidu will be visiting Malta and Romania. Vice President Naidu earlier interacted with the Indian community in Belgrade on the evening of his arrival in Serbia on Friday. And calling them India's unofficial ambassadors to Serbia, the Vice President asked the Indians living in Serbia to play a key role in deepening India-Serbia relations. VP Naidu is leading the first ever high-level Indian delegation to Serbia since the breakup of Yugoslavia in the early 1990s.
The strengthening of bilateral relationship with this beautiful country. Serbia is a very friendly country to India. They are supporting us on each and every international forum. And we don't have any contentious issues also, and we also stand firmly with the Serbian government with regard to their approach, and I am happy that the Serbian government have made e-visa on arrival. That's a very positive step taken by this government and we really appreciate the same. And our culture, particularly yoga and Ayurveda, is also attracting a lot of attention, not only here, but everywhere. I told you, secondly, reforms are in full swing. And thirdly, economy is also moving in a positive mood. So that way, everything is positive. And I welcome the businessmen from Serbia also. They can rely on India. They can also invest here. And then people who are here, they can also expand their business further, taking advantage of the growth of the country. These are some of the ideas I just wanted to exchange with you.
And news from Jammu and Kashmir now, where five militants belonging to the Lashkar-e-Toyba and the Hizbul Mujahideen were killed in an encounter in Kulgam today. The militants were holed up inside a house when the encounter with the police forces began. Security forces have recovered weapons and warlike stores from the encounter site in Chaugam area. The terrorists were involved in a series of recent terror attacks, including killing off two bank employees and many policemen. They were also involved in bank robberies and weapon looting. Aadhaar issuing body UIDAI will begin a phased rollout of the face recognition feature as an additional mode of authentication from today. UIDAI has made it mandatory for mobile operators. The authority had earlier planned to roll out the face recognition feature from 1st of July, a target that was later pushed to 1st of August. Now, UIDAI says that the move is aimed at curbing the possibility of fingerprint spoofing or cloning, and it seeks to tighten the audit process and the security around issuance and the activation of mobile SIMs. It has also proposed monetary disincentive for the telecoms that are found slipping on the prescribed targets from the next month. BJP President Amit Shah arrived in Hyderabad to begin a campaigning in the poll-bound Telangana. And during his day-long visit, Amit Shah will visit the temple of a goddess Mahakali in the old city of Hyderabad. He will also meet BJP state office bearers and district unit presidents at Kothur to discuss the strategy for the upcoming elections. He will also hold a public meeting at Mahabubnagar today. Addressing a press meet, Amit Shah earlier targeted the KCR government for forcing early elections on the people. Earlier this month, K. Chandrasekhar Rao had dissolved the state assembly in view of early polls, and the election date will be announced by the election commissioner later.
पूरे देश में लोकसभा और विधानसभा के चुनाव एक साथ होने चाहिए ऐसी मांग करने वाली पार्टी अचानक ही अपना स्टैंड बदलकर एक छोटे से राज्य को दो चुनावों के खर्चे सहन करने पर विवश किया है। जब 9 महीने बाद शेड्यूल इलेक्शन थे, 9 महीने बाद यहां विधानसभा लोकसभा के चुनाव साथ में हो सकते थे, तो मैं सीधा सवाल पूछना चाहता हूं सत्तारूढ़ पार्टी को और यहां के मुख्यमंत्री जी को कि आपने तेलंगाना की जनता पर इतना खर्चा अलग से क्यों थोपा है।
There has been an 80% decline in estimated new or HIV infections from the peak of 1995 in India, according to the latest report by National AIDS Control Organization. India has approximately 21.4 lakh people living with HIV/AIDS in 2017. Now, the report says that India saw around 87,580 new HIV infections and 69,110 AIDS-related deaths in 2017, which is a decline of 71% since 1995. India, remember, has the world's third largest population of people with HIV/AIDS after South Africa and Nigeria. On to sports news now. The 14th edition of the Asia Cup Cricket Tournament will kickstart from today with India, Pakistan, Sri Lanka, Afghanistan, Bangladesh and Hong Kong facing each other for the coveted title. Bangladesh will face Sri Lanka in the opening match, while India will face arch rival Pakistan on Wednesday on the 19th of September. Now, India, the most successful team in the Asia Cup, Pakistan and Hong Kong are placed in Group A, while Sri Lanka, Afghanistan and Bangladesh are placed in Group B. Rohit Sharma will be leading the Indian squad. The team will begin its campaign on Tuesday, the 18th of September, against Hong Kong. And India will face the Maldives in the final of the South Asian Football Federation Cup, or the SAF Cup, in Dhaka today. Chasing its eighth SAF title, India eliminated Pakistan 3-1 in the second semi-final on Wednesday. Manveer Singh was the star of that match with the two goals, while Sumit Passi scored the winner for India. The Indian team is unbeaten in the tournament so far. India has beaten Sri Lanka 2-0 and Maldives with the same score in the group stages. Maldives, on the other hand, have not played in the final in the last three editions of the SAF, losing each time in the semi-finals. Maldives earlier defeated Nepal 3-0 in the first semi-final to make it to the final. That's it in this edition of Midday News. Thanks for watching.